Hi, welcome to the WTAMU Virtual Math Lab. This video will step you through College Algebra Tutorial 7, Example 8. In this example, we want to factor the trinomial 5x squared minus 18x minus 8. Note that this trinomial does not have a greatest common factor for all of its terms, so we will go right into factoring the trinomial, which is basically doing the reverse of the FOIL method. In step 1, we want to set up a product of two binomials. In step 2, we are going to use a process of trial and error to help us figure out what terms need to go into our binomial factors. In the first terms of the binomials, we need factors of 5x squared. This would have to be 5x and x. In the second terms of the binomials, we need factors of negative 8. This would have to be negative 8 and 1, or 8 and negative 1, or 2 and negative 4, or negative 2 and 4. Since the product of these factors has to be a negative number, we need one positive factor and one negative factor. Also, we need to make sure that we get the right combination of these factors so that when we multiply them out, we get our trinomial of 5x squared minus 18x minus 8. One possible combination to try is putting the 5x and the x in the first positions and putting a plus 2 and a minus 4 in the last positions. We can check this by using the FOIL method. When we multiply the first terms out, we get 5x squared. Multiplying the outside terms, we get minus 20x. Multiplying the inside terms, we get plus 2x, and multiplying the last terms, we get minus 8. When we combine our like terms on this, we end up with 5x squared minus 18x minus 8. Hey, this is our original trinomial, so we do not need to look any further. Our final answer is 5x plus 2 times x minus 4. Don't get discouraged if you don't get the right combination on the first try. This process takes some practice. After a while, you will get used to it and be able to do it efficiently. We can always double check ourselves on factoring problems by multiplying out the factors that we have. If they multiply to be the original polynomial, then we have the right factors. If they don't, we need to go back and try factoring the problem again.